Thank you. Allowing me to see myself the way you see me. Thank you.
Okay. So, I've been blogging for a long time. But I've never done a video blog. And I thought, you know, it's time to try something new. I write all the time, and I have a lot to say to people. I just don't actually get out there and say it. You know, there's a lot of things I've done, a lot of fucked up shit that I've seen and experienced throughout my life, and I just feel like there's gotta be somebody out there that maybe if I talk to, I could help. So when I was a teenager, I always said, you know, when I get older, I want to be a motivational speaker. I want to talk to people about child sexual abuse because I myself am a survivor of incest. My dad went to prison when I was 12 for molesting me. And it doesn't define me anymore, but it definitely did some shit to me. Like, I went through a lot of shit because of that. And there's so many girls out there that I know don't want to talk about it or don't know what to say or anything. And it's really scary. And I get that. I know how scary it is. Because I lived it too. And you're not alone. So many people judge you or judge... They're really judging themselves. That's the truth. You know, people don't know, they don't know how to respond. They don't know what to say. They want to help you so bad, but they just don't know what to say to you. And if I was going to tell you anything, I would definitely tell you that you're not alone. And that you're not the one with the problem. Like, the person that hurt you is the fucked up one. And you don't have to go around feeling sorry for yourself anymore. I know that sounds kind of harsh, and I'm not trying to sound harsh at all. I'm really not. What I am trying to say is that you can't let them run your life anymore. And being afraid, and it's all understandable. But there comes a point when you have to say enough is enough, and you don't control my life anymore. You have no power over me. I'm not gonna get upset when I smell something that reminds me of you, or when I think about something, or when I see something that reminds me of you. When I go somewhere from my childhood that I want to see because I haven't seen in a long time, and then I get a flashback. Really? I'm not going to give you that control anymore. You know? And that's what it all comes down to. I want to be able to help somebody. I want to be able to say the right thing, and you know, I don't always know what to say, and I don't know where to go to find anybody to help, but I figured maybe if I could just get on here and be myself for you and tell my story, you know, and just kind of see what happens, you know. Most people, like, judge people by when you look at them and you think instantly you know all about them. Usually you don't. You know, most people definitely probably wouldn't look at me and be like, oh, that girl was molested by her dad. I also grew up in foster homes. I also tried to kill myself like over 40 times and was in and out of psych hospitals and residential treatment centers my whole life. Also did 2.5 years in prison as an adult. You know, I'm not perfect. I fucked up a lot of things, but I'm not a fuck up. And I finally get that today. So I just can't help but think that maybe there's something I could say to help somebody not feel alone anymore. And realize that as much as it sucks, everything does happen for a reason. And the stuff that happened to me has made me who I am today. And maybe I still suck sometimes, because I do. I don't always deal with things. I'm kind of a loner. Alcoholic. Don't drink anymore because of it. Because of who I become when I drink, it's not a good thing. Sometimes I can drink and be okay, and other times if I'm not dealing with my own feelings, I'm not okay. So the fact that I drink to cover up my feelings means that it's not okay for me. I'm not going to tell you not to drink, and I'm not going to tell you you're an alcoholic. I'll never say anything like that. But what I will say is that for me, drinking is not an option. That's just me. You know, part of my story is that I was molested by my dad. I'm not disgusting because of it. It's not my fault. I was a little girl. He's the one fucked up and got a problem. You gotta remember that. The person who hurt you, they're the fucked up one. They are the one with the problem. Not you. You didn't do anything.